What's up, everyone? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today, I'm in the middle of interstellar space in the middle of nowhere in Space Engine because now I'm not doing a showcase video or exploring random nebulas. Today, I'm going to start reviewing all of the star spectra main sequence stars. So before I get started, I will be going from O-type stars, which are the brightest and the most luminous and the hottest, down to the brown dwarfs, which are technically not stars, they're failed stars. So now, I won't be comparing like carbon stars, red giant stars, they're only main sequence stars, like they're not red supergiants like Betelgeuse or Stevenson 218. I'm only going to simply just main sequence stars. So the first type of spectral class I'm going to is the brightest and the most luminous and the hottest spectral class. And these are O-type stars. And I already have an O-type star right here. An O9 star. And this is HIP 64624. This is a lower class O-type star, but still, look at the luminosity. 220 of the sun, and the temperature is 33,000 Kelvin. This is a lower class O-type star, but just for fun, I will be giving you a higher class O-type star, which I will have to go, because a lot of these O-type stars I'm finding, which are real stars, are literally all supergiants, and we're looking for main sequence stars, not for anything that is very bright, like supergiants and all. So I'll be going and finding an O-type star that is high class. So it will take a while. Yes, we found one. It's an O7 star. It's slightly higher, but basically a low-class star. The luminosity is now 12,000 the sun. Temperature is 38,000 Kelvin. The biggest type of star. They're actually not the biggest main. They're not the biggest type of star, but this is a very high main sequence star. They also are known for living in a very, very short period of time. They only live for a couple million years before they completely turn into a red giant and turn into a white dwarf or go supernova if they were big enough. So this is an O-type star. The hottest temperatures, the brightest luminosity, and this is an O-type star. 11 Sagittarii. So now, what's next? Time to go to a B-type star, and this one I will be going to use the star browser. So now, I'll be searching for B-type stars nearby, and you get a lot. So I'll be going to a middle-class B-type star, which is actually in a star cluster, but it's a procedural one. But still, this is a B-type star. The diameter is 2.8 diameters, meaning it has went down by a lot. It's now a lower class and middle class B-type star. The temperature is now 13,000 Kelvin. Luminosity is now 100 of the sun, meaning it's went down by so much. Like, seriously. Now, B-type stars are known to be bluish-whitish, while O-type stars are very blue. This is just bluish-whitish. And that's B-type stars. They also have another relatively short lifespan, living for tens of millions of years until they turn into a white dwarf. They don't live as long. They live longer than O-type stars, but they still live a very short amount of time. You can see, I'm going to show you how short they live. They literally live, this one lives for only 30 million years before completely dying out. It's 15 million years old. So that's a B-type star, which is the second most luminous, brightest, hottest star spectral class in the main sequence in the entire universe. So I guess this is it. Now it's time to go to an A-type star, and you already know there's a very famous type of star that is an A-type star, and I showed it to you once. Sirius. It is a high-class A-type star. And it's very known. 8 light years away from the Earth, but I'm showing it as an example of star class. So this is Sirius, and high class A-type star, 230 million years old. Its temperature is now 9,000 Kelvin, and the luminosity is 20 of the sun. So this is an A-type star. They're also kind of rare in the universe, just like B and O-type stars. But now, I'm now officially using one A1, special class 1 or 2 V stars from now on, because we're getting to the common type of stars and it'll be done easily. And this is Sirius A, which is the luminosity's 20 of the sun. The temperature is 9,000 Kelvin, and the diameter is 1.6 of the sun, and the mass is 2 times the sun. And that's Sirius. If you want to know about that, just watch the Stars Nearby video. You can look at the first version or the second version. So that's Sirius A. Now, the next one is an F-type star, and we're going to an F1 star. So F-types and stars, unlike A-type stars are very white. F-type stars are whitish yellowish, and I found a F-type star to search. 37 Ursae Majoris, because it's in the constellation Ursa Majoris. It's in the constellation Ursa Major. So this is 37 Ursae Majoris. The temperature is 7,000 Kelvin because this is a high-class F-type star, even though other F-type stars are going to be 6,000 Kelvin. The luminosity is 5 of the sun, meaning it has went down by a little bit. The diameter went down, mass is down went down compared to the A-type star. They're still brighter and hotter and bigger than the sun, but they live a very shorter than the sun. A-type stars usually live for hundreds of millions of years, while this one lives for like 2 to 5 billion years. This one lives for just 2 billion years, meaning they have a shorter lifespan than the sun. In fact, the hotter and bigger the star is, the shorter it lives because it burns more high it does more nuclear fusion in a much faster rate, and they run out of hydrogen faster than any other star, and eventually they completely die out easier and faster. That's an F-type star, 37 Ursae Majoris, and now you know what is next after F-type stars, because we're going to the star that we are orbiting, the star everyone knows, the star literally I showed you in the Explorer solar system. Yes, this is Sol, aka our sun. It's a G-type, G2V main sequence star, and it is a G2V main sequence star with a luminosity of 1. The diameter is 1. The temperature is 5,700 Kelvin, and it's a yellowish star. They live for 6 to 12 billion years, meaning they live for longer periods of time than any other star. And I showed you sun multiple times. It's time to go to a K-type star, and the K-type stars are actually very common, but not as common as red dwarfs. So I'll be showing you a fast K-type stars. I'll be searching for it. So now, it's actually kind of common, so we're going to K1 star here. So it's just a random star, K1. It is a temperature, since this is a higher class, the temperature is 5,000 Kelvin, but the sun's 5,700 Kelvin. The diameter is 75% of the sun. The mass is 78% of the sun. They live for about 50 to 300 billion years, meaning they live longer than the sun since they're dimmer, and they do nuclear fusion much less rapidly. And this is a K-type star. Now, time to go to the most common star. This is an orangish star, and the luminosity is just 4/10 of the sun. Time to go to the most common star, which is so common I can just literally click on a random star and it gives it to me. That's right, you know what it is. It's a red dwarf! And it's so common, I can literally just click on one. M1 star, red dwarf stars. They live for the longest of any stars, and the diameter is 40% of the sun, and the mass is 41%. They're not that luminous, just 1% luminosity of the sun. The temperature is 3,500 Kelvin, and this is a red dwarf star. They're kind of the most common type of stars in the whole universe. We're not done yet, because there are something called failed stars. So failed stars are below the M class, and they are known as brown dwarfs. So I'll be going to a brown dwarf, which is also kind of common. The L-type stars are common. So I found an L-type star, and L-type stars are failed stars. The temperatures are just 1,900 Kelvin. The luminosities are basically almost non-existent at this point, even though it's kind of bright. They're mostly non-existent. And the diameter is 6 Earths, not sun. The mass is 67 Earths, and it's a failed star. Now, This is an L-type brown dwarf. It has a very orangish reddish hue to it. Time to go to the second failed star, which is known as T-type stars, which is also kind of common. So I will be going to a T2V star, which is actually very, very dim. So here's a T2V star, and they're basically mostly the lowest class round dwarfs that actually glows, and its luminosity is actually non-existent at this point, but it still glows. 6 Earths, mass is 50 Earths, the temperature is 1000 Kelvin, and basically that's all I have to show you, because Y-type stars are just basically almost non-existent, basically invisible because of how extremely non-existent they are. Now, Y-type stars, they're completely one of the most non-star things ever. So here's a Y0 star, just for fun. And the temperature is 600 Kelvin, which is actually it's just almost temperate, which is not that temperate in the Earth. It still glows slightly. The luminosity is basically not there. And that's Y-type stars. They're just basically similar to Jupiter's. Anyways, that's the rest of this video. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye, everyone.